Don't talk to me about
people. I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Ah, I believe we have some matters to discuss.
I'm here about the new spell you wanted to teach me, Professor.
Good. Professor Fig indicated a certain urgency to you completing your defensive magic assignments. As such, you are to learn Incendio, the fire-making spell, handy for lighting torches, burning away spider webs, and, when necessary, defending against those who would wish to do us harm.
Sounds versatile.
Quite. But before we get started, I'd like you to complete a few tasks. You may be surprised by some of them. Astonishing how much students don't think their professors know. When you're finished, come and see me. Then we shall begin working on Incendio. You know where to find me once you've finished.
Seems Crossed Ones isn't as secret as it's believed to be.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
He said I had a
ready for another round?
I think so. We shall see who shows up.
There's no one in the school I'd be afraid to duel.
I know, Sebastian, I know.
Glad you're back.
Hello, Lucan. May I use the training dummy?
Of course. I'll fetch it and give you a list of combinations to practice. Ready to have a try now?
That would be wonderful.
Be sure to cast all your spells before the dummy lands. If you need to stop practicing before you finish all of them, let me know. Practice. You looked good out there.
Thank you, Lucan.
I say better to discover one's weaknesses during practice than during a duel. You'll be a fearsome challenger now.
Hello, Lucan. Is the next round of Crossed Ones all set?
Why, yes it is. I've got a great match lined up. Ready for another round?
I'm ready. Let's do it.
Brilliant. Are you dueling with a partner?
Yes, Natty.
Then let's get to it.
Ready to get thrashed?
Apologies in advance.
I gave it my all.
You did indeed. The other duelists have already taken notice of you, but after that last round, they'll really have it in for you. You'd better keep practicing if you want a chance at winning, or at least surviving the next round. I'll let you know when we're ready. Hope to see you then. The next round is for all the gobstones, so to speak.
Assignment's all finished.
You could have gone a bit easier.
Perhaps I should stick to potions.
Seems I'm out of the tournament, thanks to you.
Revelio.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide.
promise you. More. Obviously.
I trust Mr. Brattleby was able to accommodate you, and that you found success in your endeavors?
I finished all of the tasks you gave me, Professor Hecate.
Glad to hear it. Then you should be ready to learn Incendio.
Should be, Professor.
Yes. I'm sorry to say, I visited enough careless colleagues at St. Mungo's to assure you that fire is a fickle servant. Your spellcasting has impressed me thus far, but please maintain focus. I would rather we not end today's lesson with your robes aflame. Let us begin. And remember, focus on the proper wand movement. Concentrate, and keep your wand steady. Good work.
Incendio!
Getting it. Keep at it. And do try not to incinerate yourself. is certainly cathartic, isn't it?
I wonder if you might be able to help me with a small, project.
You wanted to speak with me?
I did. Hello, I'm Duncan Hobhouse. Pleasure to meet you. I've heard all about you, of course, confronting trolls and dragons.
That's nice to hear. I've had my share of adventure. I hope my reputation's warranted.
I'm going to presume your reputation is, in fact, warranted. In which case, you are precisely the person I need. You see, we were learning to repel boggarts in Professor Hecate's class, and, well, mine unfortunately took the shape of a puffskeen.
Oh, they seem innocent, but their tongues can be most disturbing.
Exactly. I wish more of our fellow students agreed with you. Regardless of how reasonable I believe my fear of puffskeins to be, I'm beginning to get a reputation as a coward. Some have even taken to calling me Puffskein Dunkeen.
I'm sorry, but you have to admit that's rather clever.
I do not have to admit that. Everett said the same thing. Anyway, to make matters worse, I stupidly blurted out that I must be braver than people think, since I have been in the Hidden Herbology Corridor.
The Hidden Herbology Corridor?
Yes. Rumor has it that the herbology professor before Professor Garlic kept dangerous plants there. It's supposedly so overrun now that no one dares enter it anymore. I was hoping you could go there and bring back evidence that I could use to show that, well, I'd gone in. Say a bit of an exceptionally dangerous plant of some kind.
What sort of plant should I expect in the Hidden Herbology Corridor?
I haven't a clue. But have you seen the kinds of plants Professor Garlic grows? If the previous professor was anything like her, I'd imagine they're not exactly harmless.
Very well. If I'm in the area, perhaps I shall take a look.
Grand. I'd very much appreciate it. Come and find me if you get the proof. I shall be forever in your debt.
Hidden Herbology Corridor. Sounds intriguing.
I asked Amit Takar to tutor me in Transfiguration, but he refused. I'm a lost cause.
A beginner's guide to Transfiguration was my mistake.
Revelio!
I cannot seem to wrap my head around the subject. I thought a boy would come.
Incendio!
I spent hours trying to conjure them.
Transfiguration.
Ah!
Revelio. 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 These dry vines are one spark away from becoming kindling.
Incendio!
This must be the entrance to the hidden herbology corridor.
Incendio!
Devil's snare seems to thrive in darkness. Perhaps it doesn't care for light.
Lumos. Incendio!
Amos. Lumos. Seems the devil's snare was protecting a chest of some kind. Lumos. Incendio! Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. I imagine a piece of that enormous venomous tentacular would be enough for Duncan to prove his bravery. Lumos. Incendio. Lumos. Incendio. Lumos. Lumos. Revelio. Lumos.
Off on another adventure, are we? Revelio.
Lumos.
Have you found anything to, prove my bravery yet?
Hello, Duncan. I have the proof you wanted.
That's one leaf. Must have been a giant venomous tentacular. It's even more than I expected. I knew you were the one to ask. I appreciate you getting it for me.
Of course. I hope this helps you prove yourself.
This is sure to put an end to Puffskeen Dunkeen for good when I show everyone in the common room tonight. This'll show Everett how ridiculous that nickname was. Thank you again. And have a good day. I know I will. Thank you for all of your help. No more Puffskeen Dunkeen for me.
Ah, there you are.
Hello, sir. You'll be pleased to know that I worked on my defensive magic with Professor Hecate.
So I hear. She tells me you've taken rather well to your new wand. You must continue to work with her and your other professors to improve your skills. That said, I don't wish to postpone our visit to the library any longer. So, shall we proceed?
Fig! I have work for you. Come.
Headmaster, I'm with a student and my schedule
Your schedule will wait indefinitely, as will your student. I would think that after all the trouble you caused me with Osric, you'd be eager to make amends. My office. 5 minutes.
That man is exasperating. Unfortunately, our trip to the restricted section will have to wait a bit longer.
But, Professor...
We have no choice. It would be unwise to provoke our illustrious headmaster further. I shall find you when I've completed whatever toils I must endure.
Sebastian mentioned sneaking into the restricted section. Perhaps he'll have an idea. Sebastian, there you are.
I was hoping to see you. I was in the Three Broomsticks after the troll attack and saw what happened with Rookwood and Harlow.
Not many students have Victor Rookwood's attention. What was that all about?
Seems he's working with Ranrok, and Ranrok is after something I found at Gringotts.
Ranrok? And when were you at Gringotts?
Professor Fig and I ended up there after the dragon attack. It's quite the tale. Fig had this port...
A port key? To Gringotts? I'm not sure I follow.
I barely follow myself, and I was there. Anyway, we ended up in an ancient vault where we found a map. That map leads to the restricted section.
You can't be serious.
Deadly serious. Professor Fig has insisted that I not tell a soul about any of this. I've probably said too much.
Understood. Your secret's safe with me. Whatever it is.
Thank you, Sebastian. You mentioned being clever enough not to get caught in the restrict...
And I am. Meet me outside the library tonight, and tell no one.
Thank you, Sebastian. I'll meet you later.
Velia.
These dry vines are one spark away from becoming kindling. This must be the entrance to the hidden herbology corridor. Devil's Snare seems to thrive in darkness. Perhaps it doesn't care for light. Incendio! Lumos. Incendio! Lumos. Seems the Devil's Snare was protecting a chest of some kind. Incendio! I imagine a piece of that enormous venomous tentacular would be enough for Duncan to prove his bravery. Revelio.
How nice to see you, my young friend.
Have you found anything to, prove my bravery?
Hello.
Thank you for all of your help. No more puff scheme dunking for me.
Ah, there you are.
Hello.
So, shall we proceed?
Fig, I have work for you. Come.
Headmaster, I'm with a student and my schedule is... That man is...
Sebastian mentioned sneaking into the restricted section. Perhaps he'll have an idea. Sebastian!
I was hoping to see you. I was in the Three Broomsticks after the troll attack and saw what happened with Rookwood and Harlow.
Not many students have Victor Rookwood's attention. What was that all about?
I've never even met him. Perhaps he mistook me for another student.
If you say so. I won't press you now, but you will have to tell me what's going on at some point. You might need me. So, why were you looking for me?
I need to find something for Professor Fig, but it's in the restricted section of the library.
He can't get it himself?
He was called away by Black at the last moment. I suppose I could wait to get a note from him, but...
You want to show some initiative.
Precisely. You mentioned being clever enough not to get caught in the restricted section.
And I am. Meet me outside the library tonight, and tell no one.
What will happen if we're caught in the restricted section?
Detention, no doubt. But a word of caution or two will help. For one, avoid Peeves, the poltergeist. Aside from wanton destruction of property, he loves nothing more than telling on the likes of us.
How concerned should I be about the librarian?
Madame Scribner doesn't take kindly to clandestine activities taking place amongst her precious books. So do all that you can to avoid her.
She and I have had our entanglements, but I can hold my own against her. You may not be so lucky.
Thank you, Sebastian. I'll meet you later.
See there? That's the door we need to reach. And those annoying prefects would love nothing more than to rat on us to Scribner. So don't let them see us. Understood?
I can be sneaky. Let's go.
Hold on now. There's a spell you should know. The disillusionment charm. Good for getting places you're not supposed to be. Cast it and you'll appear as little more than a trick of the light. Just as long as you keep your distance and stay quiet.
You mean, I'll actually be able to turn invisible?
Something like that. It's not as foolproof as a cloak, but those are expensive. And spells are free. Give it a try.
I shall pretend I cannot see you. Thank you.
Ryan's still here. Quick, behind the bookcase.
Damn. You told me the librarian would be gone by now.
I said usually, but it'll still be all right. Do you see her desk behind me?
The key is in the drawer of that desk. Now, here's what we're going to do. I'll create a distraction to draw her away. You focus on getting the key. I'll meet you outside of the restricted section.
Wait, why do we need a key? Isn't there a spell for this?
Alohomora. That's how I always used to get in. But the librarian twigged that I knew the spell and cast an anti-Alohomora charm on the lock. So now it's just this key. But don't worry. I said I'd get you in, and I always keep my word. Trust me.
Is someone there? Is that you, Peeves?
That wasn't so difficult after all. Now, to find that book.
Oh, that one's charmed to look more useful than it is. It's fooled me twice. Never judge a tome by its cover, I say.
Ghost, don't let her see you.
Should be in the clear. No need for us to be skulking about.
So what is it you've been looking for?
I'm looking for a cure to help my twin sister, Anne, so that she can return to Hogwarts. Because Merlin knows everyone else has given up.
Why do you think you'll find a cure in the restricted section? Does the Hogwarts matron have nothing that can help Anne?
No. We've tried everyone from Nurse Blaney to St. Mungo's.
But I can research on my own. No need to concern yourself with that right now. Let's focus on what you're after.
Which is what, precisely?
I'll know it when I see it.
You're being awfully cryptic.
Revelio.
Silent as a grave.
Secrets of the darkest arts. I'm impressed.
Revelio.
Little friend, out exploring where they shouldn't be. Naughty, naughty, you'll get caughty.
Peeves, don't you...
I'm going to tell.
Oh, blasted Peeves. I've got to stop him or at least get to the librarian with a good excuse for all of this.
How do I know you won't go to the librarian and blame this all on me?
Why would I do that? I like having friends who are in my debt. Now go. Good luck in your search. Now, where has that damned poltergeist got to?
I know just the spell to repair this armor.
Repairer.
Lumos. Of course. Traces of ancient magic. There must be more to this room. Where might this lead? Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Lumos. Not surprising. Guards at the ready. Lumos. This must be the way forward, but to where? Lumos. Keep my wits about me. Protego! Lumos. Yeah. Lumos. It is a book after all. You wanted to see me, Headmistress Fitzgerald, Professor Rackham.
Miss Isadora Morganach, welcome.
Professor Rookwood, Professor Bacar.
We understand that you are adjusting well to life at Hogwarts.
I am.
I am glad. Especially in light of your unusual situation, starting as a fifth year.
As it happens, I was also admitted to Hogwarts as a fifth year. I've never heard of another like us.
Miss Morganach, when we spoke yesterday after class, you asked about the beautiful swirls you saw years ago when we visited your hamlet.
I recognized you all immediately. I cannot thank you enough for what you did.
We were glad to help.
And yes, I did see swirls of magic everywhere that day. My father insists it was my imagination running wild, but it was certainly real to me.
It was not your imagination.
Percival, Professor Rackham, can see them too. But we have never known of another who could.
I don't understand. What are they?
The whispers or traces that appear when a particular form of ancient magic is wielded.
Ancient magic?
Few are capable of wielding it. Hogwarts itself is a stronghold of ancient magic.
So if I can see traces of ancient magic, does that mean I can wield it too?
With the proper training.
But let us not get ahead of ourselves, Miss Morganach.
Before I can train you to wield such magic, you must first master all that Hogwarts has to offer.
A magic this powerful can do great harm in the wrong hands. It must be wielded by a select few. As such, we ask that you not speak to anyone about what we have discussed here today.
Bastion.
Sneaking in the restricted section again! I had thought we were through with this mischief. Clearly, detentions are insufficient. I'm afraid I must take this to the headmaster.
But that being said, Peeves informs me that you didn't come alone tonight. If someone has coerced you, I would have you tell me. You're a bright boy. Don't waste this.
There was nobody else. I came alone.
Oh, Sebastian. What will your uncle say?